说你们在做什么，中文或英文都可以。
Which is a comparison table for all the election, for all the party performances, for all candidates, the presidential election. So the table looks like this. Currently, we have collected over 130 political promises for among the three candidates for the presidential election.
Yeah.
And
how did you collect them, manually or?
Yeah, just manually, because these promises, they are hard. We cannot. It's pretty hard to extract them from those news.
Politicians are good at being vague.
Yeah. So mostly they are manually collected and organized from their website, official website.
Okay.
Yeah. And there are some promise that they have already made.
Publicly, yeah.
In these 2 days, we are trying to categorize them. Categorize these promises into some categories, so that we could transform this table with so many content into a more kind of size version, which looks more like a table. And how do we categorize those promises? We come across an academic paper that explains how in the political field, how do they categorize those promises?
So you're using a pre-existing.
It's called NRG coding scheme, and there are a lot of six or seven domains and a lot of dimensions that help you categorize this one for external relations. If you are open to it or you are not open to it, and they give. Each position was a code, and we just try to code then all the promises.
And is this a Taiwanese standard or is it an international?
Originally, it's an international skin code, but there is a Taiwanese scholar. He had made a Taiwanese version. So we just.
I love that there's meaningless sentences. This one of them.
I love it. Actually, there are, since, for example, when you're in European countries, Europe policies or fascism or communism consideration, but in Taiwan, most citizens are concerned about, for example, economical issues and cross-strait issues with China. So you need to make a localized version.
Once the coding scenes are done, and maybe we can have a matrix and just locate position every candidate on the matrix. Like for the external relation, the candidate A is more right wing or kind of like that.
Okay.
Are we good?
No.
It's a really cool.
It's
very cool.
Thank you.
And it's also on the Slack channel. The links to the demos.
Basically, you could just reference all the projects on the
official hack that here?
But it's in Chinese. But it's in Chinese.
What do you, I guess what impact do you hope it has, or how do you hope people will kind of use it?
Since it is a comparison table, which is like this, and this comparison table makes empty cells pretty obvious. So I hope that we could put more pressure on the candidates to elaborate their statuses and put
react
to it and
so instead of sort of skirting certain issues, they actually have to respond.
Yeah, we are also pushing the candidates as well.
Yeah.
Are you looking at doing any way that a voter could potentially fill in what their interests are and see who they align, which candidates align best with them?
Yeah, that would be interesting too. So, but we are currently trying to focus on collecting those political promises, and we make this data open, available by CCBY Program. So if there's anything that is interested in collecting the voters' wills and aggregate the voters' interest with those candidates' promises, they can directly use our promise data to do that. Yeah, so we all know that we don't have we may not have that much resource to do the to collect enough data for voters, but we could share what we have here and let other teams to do that.
Thank you.
承诺一两。